The select statement is the most frequently used SQL operation and is used to retrieve rows from a table. As of now, we've used the asterisk to select all columns in a table, but we can also select one or more specific columns to retrieve. Added to a select statement, we have the where clause that specifies a selection condition. We can use the standard operators here, as well as some that are more specific to SQL that we will look at. These operators can be applied to strings and dates, just as well as numbers. Note that the standard way to type strings and dates in SQL is using single quotes, but most database systems will also accept double quotes. The logical operators, AND OR, can be used to apply several selection conditions. If needed, parentheses are used to clarify the boundaries. The IN operator lets us list values that must be in the column to be selected. It does the same as listing them separately with the OR operator. The LIKE operator specifies a search pattern for a column using wildcards. A percentage sign selects multiple characters, so this example will select all names containing the letter A. There is also the underscore wildcard that matches a single character, so this will select names that have exactly 6 letters. The last operator is between AND that selects a range of data between 2 values. Next, if we have several rows with the same value for a column, we can add the distinct keyword to only select values that are different. There is also the limit modifier that allows us to limit the number of rows selected. It can also be used like this, which excludes the first 2 rows and gets the next 3. The order by keyword is used to sort the rows. By default, they will be ordered alphabetically or ascending. They can also be ordered again, this time in reverse numerical order or descending. To write data from a table to a file, there is the select into outfile statement. And to load the file back into a table, we use the load data infile statement.